Hi, I'm Henrik from Henrik Academy. Now we are going to discuss a lesson regarding highest common factor or HCF and lowest common multiple or LCM. I have provided this lesson, this video for my students in my school. So I think there's a lot to learn right now, so stick with me. And as always, if you like this video or you learn something useful through this video, please click like and subscribe with notification. It really helps for me. And afterwards, taking your pen and your notebook to study with me. Let's get started. HCF and LCM, or highest common factors and lowest common multiple. Firstly, regarding highest common factor, determine the highest common factor of 24 and 36. Factors of 24 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12, 24. How you got these numbers? These numbers you could have from the strategy. 24 comprised of 1 times 24, okay, or 2 times 12, or 3 times 8, 4 times 6. These numbers. So these numbers are factors of 24. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12, and 24. With the same method, you could have the factors of 36. The factors of 36 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 9, 12, 18, and 36. Look the same factors between 24 and 36. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. Okay. And 12 is the highest among of 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. So it means the highest common factors of 24 and 36 is 12. Okay, this one. All right. Now, regarding lowest common multiple, I'm going to use 24 and 36. Different with highest common factor. Lowest common multiple, you need to find multiple of 24 and 36. Multiple of 24 comprised of 24. 24 times 1, 24. 48. 24 times 2, 72. 24 times 3. 24 times 4, 96. 24 times 5, 120. 24 times 6, 144. 24 times 7, 24 times 8, and so on. Too many. And 36 times 1, become 36 times 2 equals 72 times 3 equals 108. 36 times 4 equals 1. 36 times 180. 36 times 5 equal 180. You could also find 36 times 6, times 7, and so on. Okay. Now, the common multiple of 24 and 36 are 72. This one, okay. The same multiple, right? 144, this one. And also if you gonna find 216, 288, and so on. But for lowest common multiple, we need the first same multiple, that one, 72. So the lowest common multiple of 24 and 36 is 72. This one. Okay? So that's the understanding and the difference between highest common factor and lowest common multiple. Next, we are going to learn deeply regarding HCF and LCM with several examples. First, determine HCF and LCM of 24 and 36. Yeah. I'm going to use this strategy. Okay. Factorizing strategy, factorization strategy. 24 prime factorizations. Yeah, this one prime factorizations. Prime factorizations of 24 equal 2 cubed times 3, and prime factorizations of 36 equal 2 squared times 3 squared. All right. Now, how about HCF and LCM, this one? Yeah. For HCF, you need to find the lowest number, yeah, from 2, between 2 cubed and 2 squared. So take this one, taking 2 squared, this one. And between 3 and 3 squared, okay, taking the lowest one, that is 3. Okay, so it means if 4 times 3 equal 12. So different with HCF, LCM, between 2 cubed and 2 squared, you need to find the greater. Okay, the greater is 2 cubed. Yeah. And between 3 and 3 squared, the greater is this one, 3 squared. So LCM equal 2 cubed times 3 squared. How much? 72. All right. Next, second example, determine HCF and LCM of 154, 330, and 396. Okay. With prime factorization strategy, you could find the prime factorizations of 154, 330, and 396. So this one prime factorization of 154, 2 times 7 times 11, and prime factorizations of 330 equal 2 times 3 times 5 times 11, and prime factorizations of 396 equal 2 squared times 3 squared times 11. Okay, you could learn regarding prime factorizations and prime factors on my another video. Right, HCF look the same numbers. Okay, 2 and 2 squared, but you're taking 2, the last one. Okay, don't take 2 squared, because this is the greater one. Okay, afterwards, taking 11. Yeah. So 2 times 11 equal 22. All right. Why in HCF, no need to taking 7. Why? Because 330 without 7 here in this prime factorization. Okay. Also 396 without 7 in prime factorization. Okay. Also, no need to taking 3, 2 times 3 here, because 154 without 3 in this prime factorization. Also, no need to write down 5. Okay, to taking 5 in HCF, because 154 and 396 without 5 in prime factorizations. So only 2 and 11. Different with LCM. For LCM, you need to taking all numbers. But if you have the same basic numbers like 2 and 2 squared, you need to taking the greater one, that is 2 squared. It's 1. Okay? And between 3 and 3 squared, taking this one, 3 squared, the greater number, don't take 3. Yeah. And afterwards, 5. Okay. Write down 5 here. And afterwards, 7. This one. Okay. And 11. This one. Okay. There are 3 11, but you have to write down only 1 11 here. No need to write down 11 times 11. No, just 1 11, right? So 4 times 9 times 5 times 7 times 11, the result equal 13,860. Okay, so that's the difference between HCF and LCM. You need to find first the prime factorizations of the numbers before you determine the HCF and LCM. Next, for question and answer one, this word problem regarding HCF and LCM. A charitable organization distributes 420 packets of rice, 168 bottles of oil, and 504 oranges equally among some senior citizens. Find the greatest possible number of the senior citizens. It means we need to find a highest common factor, I think. Okay. The prime factorizations of 42, this one, 42, 168, and 504. Yeah. This one, prime factorization of 420. This prime factorizations of 168 and prime factorizations of 504. Okay. So how to determine the HCF? Yeah. 2 squared. Why? Look, the same basic number, only this one. Okay. And the smallest one, okay, the lowest one, this one, 2 squared. Okay. The smallest number or the lowest number, 2 squared, yeah, between 2 cubed and 2 to the power 6, right? Among of 3 numbers, 2 squared is the last one. So HCF, or highest common factors of 420, 168, and 504 is 4. Yeah, from 2 squared. Okay, no need to taking 3, because 504 prime factorization without 3. Okay, no need to taking 7 as well, because 504 prime factorizations here without 7 as well. And also no need to taking 5, write down 5 here, because in here, in 504 prime factorization without 5, also 168 without 5 in prime factorization. So the HCF 2 squared equal 4. Like, so it means the greatest possible number of the senior citizens is 4. Q&A number 2, buses A, B, and C are at a bus interchange. So it is a bus interchange at intervals of 20 minutes, 30 minutes, and 45 minutes. Respectively, if all of them are at the interchange at 8:30 a.m., find the time when they will meet at the next interchange. Okay. Okay, so they start from the first interchange at 8:30 a.m. and we're gonna find what time they're gonna meet at the next interchange. Okay, with the intervals 20 minutes, 30 minutes, and 45 minutes. Okay, firstly, we need to find the prime factorizations of 20, 30, and 45, such as this one. Okay. 20 equal 2 squared times 5, 30 equal 2 times 3 times 5, and 45 equal 3 squared times 5. All right. Next, we're going to find LCM. Okay, LCM of 20, 30, and 45. And the LCM of 20, 30, and 45 equal 2 squared. Okay, because between 2 and 2 squared, okay, the highest one or the greater number equal 2 squared. So we need to write down here 2 squared. Right, afterwards, 3 squared, because between 3 and 3 squared, the highest one or the greater one equal 3 squared. So write down here, times 3 squared. All right, afterwards 5. Okay, there are 3 5, but you have to write down only one 5 here. So it means how to find the LCM of 20, 30, and 45. 2 squared times 3 squared times 5. And we get 180 minutes. Okay, 180 minutes equivalent with 3 hours. Okay. So 8:30 plus 3 hours, 8:30 a.m. 3 hours later equal 11:30 a.m. I think. Yeah, this one. So buses A, B, C will meet at the next interchange when 8:30 plus 3 hours. So they're gonna meet at the next interchange at 11:30 a.m. Right. Now find the HCF of 6x squared, y cubed, and 8x cubed, y squared, and 12 x to the power 4 and y cubed, and 10 x cubed and y to the power 4. All right, how to find the HCF of 4 terms? First term, second term, okay, and third terms, and this one, fourth terms. Firstly, we need to find the prime factorization. Prime factorizations of this one, 6 square x and 6 square x y cube equal this one, 6. Prime factorization of 6 equal 3 times 3, 2 times 3. And this one, square x, because square x and y cube. Okay. And next, how about prime factorizations of 8x cube y square? This one. Yeah. 2 cube equal 8, right? So prime factorizations of 8x cube y square equal 3 cube times x cube times y square. Next, 12 x to the power 4 and y cube. The prime factorizations equal 2 square times 3 times 4 to the power x to the power 4 times y cube. Next, 10 x cube y to the power 4. This one, the prime factorization. Okay. 2 times 5 times x cube times y to the power 4. Now, SCF, 2 times x squared times y squared. Why 2? Because look, among of 2, 2 squared and 2 cubed, the lowest one or the smallest one number equal 2. Okay. So therefore, you need to find, you need to write down here 2, not 2 squared or 2 cube. Okay, just find the last one. No need to write down 3 because 8x cube y square prime factorizations without 3 here. Okay, no need to write down 5 as well because 8 x cubed, 8x cubed, y squared, also 12, x to the power 4, y cubed, without 5. Okay? So, therefore, we write down 2 here. No need to write down 5 and 3. Okay? Okay. Let's continue. Next. Times x squared. Why x squared? Look, there are x squared, x cubed, x to the power 4. Okay. Okay, among of x squared, x cubed, x to the power 4, which one, the lowest one or the smallest one? This one, x squared. So therefore, x squared here, right? Afterwards, y squared. Okay, y cubed, and y to the power 4. Among of them, which one is smallest? This one, the smallest one, or the lowest one, is y squared. So therefore, times y squared here in HCF. Okay. So the result is one, the HCF, 2x squared y squared, or you could simplify become 2xy squared, like this, right? Next, LCM. How to find LCM of, the same terms, I think. This one, and this one. Okay, 4 terms. As usual, we need to find prime factorization of these 4 terms. This one, okay, but different with HCF. If you're gonna find LCM, you need to take the greatest one, the highest one. It's just as this one. Among of 2 cube and 2 square, which one the greatest one or the highest one? This one. Okay. 3 cube. So write down here 3 cube. Afterwards, 3. Okay, so write down here 3, and afterwards 5. Only one 5 here. Write down 5 here, and then x to the power 4 among of x. Cube, x to the power 4, and x squared. Which one the highest one or the greatest one? This one, x to the power 4. So therefore, this one, x to the power 4, you write down here. Afterwards, y. Among of y cube, y squared, and y to the power 4. Which one the highest one? Of course, this one, okay? Y to the power 4. So it means the LCM or lowest common multiple of these terms, okay? For these 4 terms equal 8 times 3 times 5 times x to the power 4 times y to the power 4. And this one, 120, because 8 times 3 times 5. Okay, or you could simplify this 120x to the power 4y to the power 4, you could simplify, become 120xy to the power 4 here. Okay. Yeah. This for your exercise. Okay, find the HCF and LCM of these problems, number 1 till number 7. Okay. Students, if you have any questions or something happened or maybe not understand yet regarding this topic, you could send me a message through henrik.academy21@gmail.com. Yeah. Thank you for watching. See you.